By 7 a.m., students had started thronging the Makerere University premises. Security was a bit tight, with more security officers deployed at several entries and exits of the university. One had to be subjected to thorough checking, including showing their identification, before they would be allowed inside the university premises. Students were happy that the universities have finally reopened after a long wait. However, at the School of Social Sciences at Makerere University, they started their day one with a petition to the university management. Brian Arinete, who led his colleagues, said they were unhappy with the university exams timetable and they want it changed.
We are all expecting to have physical classes, but unfortunately, the lecturers are not turning up. We don't know what is going on the ground. And what is giving us headache? These guys issued that timetable that exams are supposed to start on 15th November. And remember, we have been having online lectures. And there's this scenario whereby some people are living very far in the village, where that some even don't have smartphones, as you know, current Uganda. But they are seeing things to be more favorable, that everyone is contented with what is going on. Some people don't even afford how to buy a data every day. Really, we are suffering, and we call upon people who are interested in this to come and really pass.
We want full physical lectures, not just online, because that time when it can be a day when I've just woken up, I have that data, but then my network is poor. Then I wake up another day, I don't have that data, and I don't have someone to actually say, because we pay a lot of fees, yeah? The students actually pay a lot of fees. But then the administration has not come up to say, maybe let's put something that's going to provide data for the students. Yeah.
The semester calendar for Makerere University for 2020-2021, which has been issued out by the Vice Chancellor, Professor Barnabas Nawangwe, indicates that semester dates remain as approved by Senate from the 30th of August 2021 to the 29th of January 2022. Finally, some graduate students have reported today, 1st November, and they are to attend physical lectures for 2 weeks, ending on the 13th of this month.
I don't know what happened, I think, during the update.
Finally, some graduate students will see their exams for 2 weeks, starting from the 15th to the 27th of this month. First year students will hold online studies from the 29th of November to the 24th of December. Second year and all other continuing students will study online from the 1st to the 27th of November. Second year students and all other continuing students will report to the university for the physical lessons for 4 weeks from the 27th of November to the 24th of December, among others. Meanwhile, security has been tightened at the Uganda Christian University campus, as students reported today. Security has been manned by both Uganda police and a private security company. Students upon arrival are expected to get out all their belongings from their vehicles for thorough checking. The students have told us that they had waited for this day after they got tired of staying home. The university spokesperson Frank Obonyo says they have linked up with the district health department to see that they carry out COVID-19 tests on each student at the campus.
We are also working with the district health office to ensure that all students who come here, who report to campus, are screened. That is going to happen this week. They will also all be screened. And then they have opportunity, and we urge them to take the COVID-19 vaccinations. That exercise is going to take place this week. And all this is to ensure that they are safe within campus.
In Bara, Bishop Stewart University opened amidst observance of standard operating procedures. This was done to avoid the spread of COVID-19 among students and staff, a fulfillment of the presidential directive to reopen all institutions of higher learning on the 1st of November. Nicholas Washasha Chiza, a security officer, said they ensured observance of the security procedures and COVID-19 standard operating procedures for everyone who wants to access the institution premises.
Yeah, we adhere to standard operating procedures set by the Ministry of Health and other regulations that come with from time to time. So basically, whenever one reaches at the main gate, entering into the main campus or other campuses, we do the screening using temperature guns. And whenever we establish that there is a person whose temperature reads more than 37, so we refer to the health personnel for further management.
We have we have very big space, enough space for first years to come and study observing social distancing.